Host and editor of the Autocar Show, Renuka Kriplani, is taking Delhi-based businessman Akhil Ghai through the paces of being an auto journalist on this edition of The Assignment. The first task was fuel testing the car. Task 2 required him to speed test the car, followed by a cone obstacle test. The moment of reckoning is here. Akhil gets ready to be judged by his mentor. Akhil, you've been out on the road. How are you feeling now? You've done the slalom. You've learned how to handle the car.
It was
a first for you.
It was an absolute fun. Absolute fun. No other word to say.
Really? And he did pretty well too on the slalom, I must say. We pushed him a little bit and timed him as well just to get him to go that little bit quicker. But he did it well.
Lots of people lose control on the car while driving fast. Driving fast is something different, and controlled fast driving is something different. So
actually, to know how hard to push and not go beyond the limit,
yeah,
which I think he did pretty well. And I think he had good fun with the Wii box. We were challenging each other and seeing who could get the better timing.
So I was about 0.5 seconds slower than her.
So he learnt how much difference it actually makes when you shift right,
yeah,
when your launch is right. And actually how much it is in terms of seconds and time. You know, you don't really feel it out there on the road. It all feels quick. But when you actually put it down and the GPS is giving you the figures, you realize those little nitty-gritties, how much difference they make. Most people would just start up the car and drive, but he did rev the engine. He did try to launch the car.
Mm.
Got a little extra wheel spin, which is what got him a little slow. But he learned quick,
right,
and he was adapting as he went along.
Sure.
And I think after I did the first few runs and then he went into the car again, he bettered his time instantly. So he picked it up really quick.
So now, if you are going to rate him on this second task that you were allotted to him, in terms of a scale of 1 to 10, how well do you think he's done this time?
I'd give him a 6 on the V-Box and a 9 on the slalom, so I'd have to say it's an 8 for him all round.
An 8 is not bad at all. He started off with a 5 for the first task, an 8 on the second one. I can't wait to see what you do on the third task. What is it going to be, Renuka?
Well, he wanted to be an auto journalist, so that's exactly what we're going to ask him to do. We've given him the car after having finished his task. Then he's going to have to evaluate the car and tell us what he thinks, what his perspective of the car is. A sort of a short review of this new 1.5 Vertio Sleeper. And I want you to be incredibly creative. So, it's the digital age now. We want you to do it on this.
Wow.
Thank you.
This is how auto journalists today would do it, is it?
Absolutely. On the go.
All right. So, good luck with this assignment.
Thank you. Thank you.
Have fun.
It was a big challenge for me. I had to be very crisp and very short and write down all that experiences which I felt throughout the day in just 400 words, as if somebody is saying me, you describe your life in 10 words. I'm planning to mention about the handling of the car, how car responded on the corners while driving, what kind of noises come from the cabin, and how much power I can feel while driving the car. Then you know that you are writing something which is your dream job. You have to be more cautious about that. You cannot be over expressive, you cannot be, you know, under expressive. You have to write the right thing. What I can expect from Renuka is she'll be able to understand my perspective, my viewpoint, that I have seen this car as a customer, I have seen this car as a youngster, I have seen this car as a stable-headed man who wants to drive a car for his family, not for doing some sporty stuff. So whether he should buy the car or not.
Here you are, you have been working very hard.
Yeah.
You almost look like a student straight out of school.
Yeah.
Having finished an exam.
No.
Now he's looking nervous. You know, before he walked in smiling, now he's looking a bit nervous.
Alright, let's see what you've done. Why don't you read out what you've written?
Okay. Toyota ETO Sleeva 1.5 liter 90 PS TRD is the car I have tested today. At a glance when I saw the car, I was quite disappointed that my first job as an auto journo is to test a duckling looking car with almost no power as compared to its closest rivals like Swift, Fabia, Polo and i20. One thing that I liked in the exterior are the 15 inches smoked TRD alloy rims. The car was a bit surprised for me as there were no significant changes in the interior, but I could feel the punch as compared to the 1.2 variant. The peak performance of the motor can be felt between 3000 RPM to 4500 RPM, but on higher gears and lower speeds, the car is not as responsive as I was expecting. So from a customer's point of view, this car may not be the cup of tea for the people who look for fuel economy, but it can be termed as a hot hatch as it matches up the expectation of jazzy younger pals who believe in showing off some sporty stuff in lesser price tag.
I liked his conclusion actually. I think he has some pretty accurate points there that, you know, it is a niche segment. It is for a few people who want that sportiness. It's not a mass appeal car. The, you know, people looking for hatches are generally looking for fuel economy. Few things that I found missing in his story, let's begin with. There was no mention of comfort levels. The seats have changed in this Liva. They're far more comfortable now. You know, the fact that it's a spacious hatch still, that remains, you know, the predominant factor about it. Something that I would totally disagree with him on is the fact that it actually handles better than the Swift or the Fabia. For me, those two cars are way more stable, they're far more balanced, they have less roll into the corners, the steerings are sharper. I'm 100% sure that when you do a back-to-back test and you drive both of them together on the same road, on the same stretch, you will see that difference immediately.
How do you rate him on this last task on a scale of 1 to 10?
Well, I'm going to be fair because this is his first shot at it. I think he did a good job and he would get an 8 from...
I'm sure, Akhil, you have questions on your mind. Being a businessman at this stage, thinking of being an auto journalist, what's the thought?
I just want to ask one thing, Renuka. I mean, if someone wants to be a freelance auto journalist...
Like you.
Like me. So, I mean, what is the appropriate way?
I guess it's not that easy. I don't know of many freelance auto journalists. What eventually happens is... you're affiliated to a magazine or to a newspaper or to a website. So a lot of people are now driving cars and writing their own blogs. And that's the way to start, because you write your own blog, you get more people to read it, and it's a beginning. And if you get really popular, and you know, it's then easy to walk into a magazine or a newspaper and say, hey, look, people love my articles. So can I write with you or can I test with you? And it's a beginning, you know, so it's a way to start.
Lots of takeaways from this edition of The Assignment, and obviously there is a big takeaway for Akhil this time as well. The phone on which you've written the article now belongs to you.
Thank you very much. I believe in this thing that dream is not that what you see while sleeping. Dream is something which never lets you sleep. After this experience, my passion has grown up 100 times.